So to proceed with my first slide, the most common presenting breast-related problems in men include pain and palpable mass, and ultrasound is usually the first-line investigation and mammography in some institutes. So CT scan is only performed to rule out metastasis in suspected or diagnosed patients, and MRI is not as much used in male breast pathologists as in female. So the etiologic spectrum in a male breast pathologist include gynecomastia, pseudogynecomastia, papilloma, adenoma, myofibroblastoma, granular cell tumor, fibrocystic change, diabetic mastopathy, epithelial inclusion cyst, cystic lymphangioma, varices, leiomyoma, and lipoma. Among malignancies, the most common pathologies infiltrating ductal carcinoma, and other uncommon pathologies include liposarcoma, lymphoblastic lymphoma, and metastasis. Among infiltrating ductal carcinoma, the most common pathology including invasive ductal carcinoma. Male breast cancer, though rare, usually presents at an advanced stage than in women due to delayed diagnosis and early tendency to metastasis. So it is very essential to recognize the malignant features and differentiate it from benign features like gynecomastia. However, any suspicious lesion, if benignity or gynecomastia is not definite, and if there is a diagnostic difficulty, biopsy is essential. So the aim of my study is to recognize the characteristic radiologic features of benign and malignant breast diseases and to describe the imaging features of gynecomastia and its differentiation from breast cancer. So it is, most of the patient referred to radiology for breast symptoms were evaluated with ultrasound. So out of 35 patients in my study, most of the 23 patients had gynecomastia and other benign pathologies, and only one patient had a ductal carcinoma. So gynecomastia usually presents with a bilateral, soft, mobile, tender subareolar mass, and the usual age of presentation is puberty and more than 50 years, and by definition it is more than or equal to 2 cm subareolar mass in a non-obese man. And on ultrasound, the typical appearance is a subareolar ill-defined lobulated or spiculated hypoechoic mass with extensions into the surrounding tissue. So these are the examples of gynecomastia. So it is hypoechoic mass, it has spiculations or ill-defined irregular margins, and so it is usually bilateral, but such characteristic lesion in women is usually considered malignant, but in male such a lesion is usually gynecomastia, provided it is bilateral and subareolar, and it is usually soft and tender. And pseudogynecomastia is a deposition of fat in an obese man, and it is also usually bilateral. Myofibroblastoma is a fibroadenoma-like looking lesion in male breast, and it is usually isoechoic, well-defined, has well-defined margins, and it may be formed. So these are examples of other benign lesions. Lymphangioma is usually seen in a child, and it is a multiloculated cystic lesion, and there is a usual history of presence of such mass in from very early age group. And this is epidermoid inclusion cyst, seen in any other part of the body. So differentiation between gynecomastia and breast carcinoma. So breast carcinoma is usually firm, tender, and non-mobile mass. It is usually eccentric, unlike gynecomastia, usually unilateral and hypoechoic. But it may be vascular, complex, and usually presents with axillary lymphadenopathy or metastasis to other organs. So this is an example of one such patient in our institute. There was a mass in the right breast. So went for CT, and the patient showed hepatic, pulmonary, pleural, and mets all around, and the original mass was very small, but the patient had widespread mets, and male breast pathology which is suspicious or in a high risk patient like positive family history, chest wall irradiation, hyperestrogenism, BRCA2 mutation, undescended testis, orchidectomy, So any such lesion or high risk lesion with or without high risk radiological features, high risk history should be evaluated very suspiciously, and biopsy if needed should be performed. So to conclude, gynecomastia is the most common male breast pathology. It is usually, as mentioned earlier, it is usually bilateral subareolar painful mass. And it should be ruled out before diagnosing any other pathology. Malignancy, though uncommon, it usually presents at a more advanced stage than in women. So any male breast lesion, if not gynecomastia or classically benign, needs to be biopsied. So recognition of radiological high risk or malignant features is very essential while examining symptomatic male breast. And so any lesion in a high risk male or any lesion having high risk radiological features or high risk clinical features, like if it is firm, if there is a bleeding from nipple, if the lesion is unilateral, eccentric, it needs to be evaluated, and biopsy needs to be performed or further investigation is mandatory. So these are my references. And thank you all.